Hello, people.
Oh, you're looking good today. We've got a great day ahead of us, and we've all been working together as a team to make this a great day for you. I promise that you're going to enjoy today, okay? I mean it. And I asked the team to promise me that they would do their very best today, and they promised. Let me just check in with them, and we'll get started if they're ready. Okay, everybody, I've promised these kids a great morning. Are you ready to give it to them? Yes, they promised me that everything is ready to go. And that's good because I'm ready to go too. Are you? Great, then you know what that means. Places.
Today, we want you to know that God sent Jesus to earth to save people from their sins. Hey, that's cool. God made a promise, and he kept it. God's promise was Jesus. Let's say the life point again. God sent Jesus to earth to save people from their sins. We're going to hear today about two people who saw Jesus, God's promise, and were very happy. In fact, our Bible verse today is what one of them said when he saw Jesus. It's from Luke chapter 2, verse 30. For my eyes have seen your salvation. God sent Jesus to earth to save people from their sins. God promised to send Jesus, and he did it. That's the best promise of all. It's so awesome. Let's worship and sing our praises to God.
Hello, Shipwreck Community Church. Matt Sanders here. If you're like me, you've eaten too much candy, played too many games, and you've opened your last Christmas gift. Christmas has come and gone once again. Well, for most of us anyway.
I know December 25th has passed, but I believe we can still do the Christmas pageant.
The Christmas pageant that was scheduled for Christmas Eve never happened due to the admitted selfishness of the three would-be directors.
At first, I was mad at everyone else too, but I knew it was really our own fault.
Because of our pride, we completely ruined the Christmas pageant.
I don't know if I've ever been more embarrassed of myself.
Apparently, they're ready to give it another go, with Arthur Trident producing the project. He was able to convince them and the rest of the cast and crew to do exactly what he says.
Let's give this another go. I want everyone's signature of commitment on this. We have but one purpose with this Christmas pageant: to remind people that God sent Jesus as a baby to save us all from sin. Who does what part is irrelevant. It's our job to work together to cast one vision of hope to the people watching the pageant.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
To that end, everyone will draw from this hat what position they will be doing.
What?
Unprecedented.
I have a contract that you all signed. Who's first?
I'll draw first.
I'm Mary.
Okay. Stage manager.
Delightful.
The angel of the Lord.
Shepherd.
Director.
Joseph.
Whew.
It will be the greatest sheep ever.
The innkeeper's wife?
I'm a wise man.
Shepherd. All right.
Narrator?
I don't really know how to direct. I'm not used to being off stage.
I've never taken direction. I've only given it.
This is what rehearsals are for, to figure out how to do something. The most important thing is that they were all willing to humble themselves to glorify God. And something amazing happened.
I knew that Tanya had never directed before, so I gave her some leadership tips from my days as student body president.
Olivia and I are used to each other's parts, so we gave each other pointers. She helped me to speak louder.
It's called projecting. And Anderson showed me some great ways to keep props and costumes organized.
Everyone started helping each other. They put away their selfish desires and worked for the good of the whole pageant. It was going to be a huge success because it was finally about God instead of us.
Everybody, I can't believe it. I just got a text from my best friend. It says that she is coming to visit me. I cannot wait. I moved away several years ago and I haven't seen her in so long. This text says that she's coming in just a few weeks. In fact, she promised me she would be here. This is great news. I can't wait until I get to see her in person and give her a hug. That kind of reminds me of the story we're going to hear. Do you remember the names of the two people we are meeting today? Simeon and Anna, that's right. First, let's talk about Simeon. Just like me waiting for my friend to come visit, Simeon was waiting for someone. In Luke 2, we read that when the baby was only 8 days old, Mary and Joseph gave him the name Jesus, just as the angel had told them. Soon after that, Mary and Joseph took Jesus to the temple in Jerusalem. At the temple, they offered a sacrifice of 2 turtle doves, or pigeons. This was what the law required after the birth of a baby. Simeon, a faithful and righteous man, was at the temple on the same day. The Holy Spirit had promised Simeon that he would not die before he saw the Messiah, God's chosen one. Can you imagine that? Simeon was there at the temple waiting for Jesus. When Joseph and Mary entered the temple, Simeon took Jesus into his arms and praised God. Listen to what Simeon said in Luke 2. "Now, Master, you can dismiss your slave in peace as you promised, for my eyes have seen your salvation." Mary and Joseph were amazed at what Simeon said about Jesus. Simeon told Mary that Jesus would cause the fall and rise of many people in Israel and would cause the thoughts of many people to be made known. God kept his promise, and Simeon held the promised Messiah. Simeon said the words of our Bible verse for today. He said, "My eyes have seen your salvation." Simeon knew that he was seeing God keep his promise. Someone else was in the temple area that day. Anna was an old woman who never left the temple. She stayed near the temple night and day, praying and fasting or going without food. When Anna saw Jesus, the Bible says that she came up and thanked God and then began to tell everyone who had been waiting for the Messiah that he was finally here. He had come. God kept his promise so many years ago when he sent Jesus, the Messiah, who all those people had been waiting for. Jesus was the Savior of the world then, and he's still the Savior of the world now. God's promise wasn't just for those people all those years ago. His promise is for us today too. Anyone who trusts Jesus as their Savior becomes part of God's family. Will you pray with me? Dear God, you always keep your promises. You never forget and you never fail. You sent Jesus to be the Savior of the world, to be my Savior and anyone's Savior who believes in Jesus. Thank you for Jesus, your free gift of salvation. In Jesus' name, amen.
God kept his promise so many years ago when he sent Jesus, the Messiah. Who are those people has been waiting for? Jesus was the Savior of the world then, and he's still the Savior of the world now. God's promise wasn't just for those people all those years ago. His promise is for us today too. Anyone who trusts Jesus as their Savior becomes part of God's family. God kept his promise and sent his Son to be the Savior of the world. He is Messiah, our Savior. Let's celebrate Jesus together.
Celebrate, let's celebrate Jesus, God with us, Emmanuel. Celebrate. Hey guys, Simeon and Anna were so excited when Mary and Joseph brought the baby Jesus to the temple area. They praised God for sending Jesus, the Savior. Is it still possible today, even though we can't see Jesus physically, that we can celebrate Him? What do you think you would have done if you had seen baby Jesus in person?
I would have just hugged Him and said hi, and I would have felt really awkward and been like, this is Jesus.
If I was like transported into the future, into the back in time, I would have seen Him and gone like, oh, He's Jesus. He would change the world. He would help blind men see. He would help lepers be healed and all those other cool things.
I would freeze and just look up like, that's amazing. Just, wow.
Probably had a surprised face on, and I would probably run up and hug Him immediately.
I would probably pass out, to be quite honest with you. I'd be very excited. I would probably give great praise, as you know. Just being able to actually see Jesus as a baby in person would be actually quite a lot to take in.
What is your favorite way to show others that you celebrate Jesus?
By telling them about Him and maybe inviting them to my church.
Loving others, being kind to others.
I give my friends gifts. I just like giving to them to show them my joy.
Tell them to come over to my house and we would express our ways of how we do things, how we do Christmas, how we do Easter.
Can you celebrate Jesus by yourself?
You can by just embracing that He came down and He turned and He came to die on the cross for our sins, and He didn't just come down to see us and say hi. He came down to die on our sins, to die on the cross for our sins, and that's just really cool.
I pray to Him, and I worship Him.
I like going to church with my parents and my family.
You can just celebrate your love as in singing praises to Him, going to church, showing His love to others. Maybe even leading friends of yours to Him, even. That is pretty much how I usually celebrate it.
Isn't it great news that we can celebrate the birth of Jesus 2,000 years later because He is still alive and well? God loves you and He wants you to learn to worship Him in real life.
Aren't you glad God kept His promise? Let's say this together so we don't forget. God sent Jesus to earth to save people from their sins. Remember what Simeon said when he saw Jesus? Let's say it together. For my eyes have seen your salvation. Luke chapter 2, verse 30. Simeon knew God had kept His promise. God sent Jesus. You too can know God always keeps His promises. We'll talk again next week.
See, I told you today would be a great day. We kept our promise. But you know what's even better than us keeping our promise? God keeping His promise to send Jesus to be the Savior of the world. I'm super happy that He sent Jesus and that Jesus came willingly. Aren't you? Be sure to grab your One Conversation pages on your way out. It'll help you talk with your family about what you've learned. And that's a wrap, everybody. Great job. Don't miss next week.
Messiah, who reigns forever, no one
Jesus.